question is, the Northwest has some of the highest rates of sex trafficking in the nation. What have you done and what will you do to address this?
This is an important question. This is important because of my experience related to mental health. I have worked with several patients who experienced significant trauma in their lifetime. This is also important to me because sexual assault leads to significant declines throughout people's lifetime. It can lead to psychological conditions that can sometimes be irreparable. Regarding to things I have specifically done, I have worked in trauma and violence clinics. I had an opportunity to work at Planned Parenthood when I was a family medicine resident. I had an opportunity to meet survivors and talk to them about their experiences and help counsel them and how they can reframe and recollect their lives. Regarding to what I believe we should do as a city, is there is absolutely zero tolerance for this behavior. Zero tolerance means being extremely strict and not accepting an excuse or a justification for why something happened. I can tell you there is a case right now related to people who worked at Microsoft who are on this front line. I have worked with those patients in my clinic at the Shoreline Family Medicine Center. And I can tell you, it devastated their lives. This issue impacts everyone, and everyone is harmed, and no one can ever be clean when these happen. Thank you.
Has been left to fend for itself. It is being isolated pretty much from the rest of Seattle. We spoke earlier, we heard earlier of the traffic congestion and the time that it takes away from spending time with our families. That's most important. We need real solutions. Not talking about how bad it is, but really, if you're going to talk the talk, walk the walk. So what does that mean? How do we build creatively transportation here for West Seattle in a true, meaningful, financially backed way? That goes into widening the roads and creating the bike lanes. It goes into making sure that we've got full resources of more bus routes. It goes into, if we're not going to get the light rail, what do we do next? It's being truly committed financially to transportation here in West Seattle. I agree, this area of Seattle has been ignored. We've all been suffering too many times. And so part of it is making sure we're implementing realistic solutions, understanding the urgency of now. We've got jobs, we've got families that we have to care for, and we need to make sure that we're answers, solutions, and money. Thank you.
So your question is, what would be your recommendation to builders/developers to address the affordable housing crisis?
So I am a renter, and if elected to Seattle City Council, I would be the only renter sitting on Seattle City Council right now. There's about just over 50% of the residents in Seattle who are renters, and we need to have a voice up there on City Council. Because right now, if you look across all of Seattle, we have a housing crisis. And I mentioned before that homelessness, I look at as a public health crisis that it is. Lack of affordable housing is a public health crisis. We cannot have access, thank you. We cannot actually be able to go out and access the jobs and economic security that we need if we're constantly worried about whether or not we have mold in our communities, whether or not we have leaky roofs. We cannot actually have adequate health in our communities if we don't have the housing we need. Now, I want to see us move forward with the affordable housing requirements and see it as a floor. A floor because we ought to be doing more to create more affordable housing options in a city like Seattle. A city as prosperous as Seattle, we ought to have greater shared prosperity. And so I look at it like I look at the Affordable Care Act. A lot of you know that I sat on the Exchange Board for 4 years, and I fought like hell to make sure that everybody got the health coverage that they needed. And a lot of us were really disappointed that we didn't have the health subsidies that we needed, that it wasn't covering everybody. And you know what I kept saying? That needs to be the floor. We need to do healthcare right in our state and in our city. And that's what I want to do. See the recommendations as the floor and make sure that we're doing right by our cities, by our residents, by communities of color who have historically dealt with redlining and are currently getting pushed out. One of the most significant things that we can do to address gentrification and displacement is create affordable housing options for everybody in this city. It is a human right issue, it is a healthcare issue, it is a worker justice issue, and it is something I will fight for and make sure you're with me on that.
Affordable housing. There are some really great candidates in front of you tonight. And the way that you have to make decisions is that at the end of the day, this is not going to be a campaign of right versus left or left versus left. This is a campaign of vagueness versus specifics. And I'm being very specific with my housing policy platform. I'm calling for a mandate for 25% of every new building to be affordable to working class people. I'm calling for a right for renters to have the ability to collectively bargain for their rental agreements over price and quality. I am talking about creating an office of the tenant advocate, because what good are the laws if they go unenforced? There is no other candidate in this race who has put forward specificity, specifics, because if you're not specific, how can you as voters hold the candidate or the politician accountable? Yeah. That is the question in front of you tonight. It's not just housing too. I've also put forward the most specific policy on police reform as well. And if a candidate isn't willing to say that they want civilian oversight for our police department, that says something. Now, I think that as far as affordable housing goes, I fully supported the 1,000 Homes campaign. But the way that we get there matters. It can't be through regressive property taxes. We have some of the biggest corporations in this city. We have Amazon, we have Facebook, we have Microsoft. We should be imposing a corporate tax to build 1,000 homes for working class and low-income people. That is something that I strongly support, and I'll be just fighting tooth and nail for renters and also for low-income homeowners in the city of Seattle. I ask for your vote, I ask for your support, and pay attention to the specifics of what people are telling you they're going to do.